Hello students, in today's class we are going to discuss about the XML. What are the design goals of XML and what are the various advantages, disadvantages and application of XML. In previous class we discussed about the XML and how to create a DDD file, document definition, file. Now basically there are various goals of designing the XML. Basically, XML shall be straightforwardly usable over the internet. XML is one most of the popular language for the internet. XML shall support a wide variety of applications. And XML shall be compatible with the standard generalized markup language. It shall be easy to write programs which process XML documents. The number of optional features in XML is to be kept to the absolute minimum, ideally zero. The XML document should be human legible and reasonably clear. So the XML design should be prepared quickly. The design of the XML shall be formal and concise. And XML documents shall be easy to create. Terseness in XML markup is of minimal importance. So these are the design goals of XML. Now going to advantages and disadvantages of XML. So advantages of XML. XML is a platform independent and programming language independent. Thus it can be used on any system and support the technology change when that happens. So XML can be used with the any type of programming languages, like you can use with the DevEx, asynchronous JavaScript and XML. So JSON, you can use with the JSON. So there are so many programming languages available which uses the XML because it is used to store and transfer the transporting of the data. So which application platform requires storing and transporting the data, they use the XML for it. XML also supports Unicode. Basically Unicode is an international encoding standard for use with different languages and scripts by which each letter, digit or symbol is assigned a unique number value that applies across different platforms and programs. This feature allows XML to transmit any information written in any human languages. This is the very important feature. So due to its Unicode support, information can be written in any human language can be transmitted. Another advantage is the data stored and transported using XML can be changed at any point of time without affecting the data presentation. Generally, other markup languages such as HTML is used for data presentation. Yes, as we already discussed the difference between HTML and XML. So HTML is used for data representation. So HTML gets the data from XML and display it on the GUI, graphical user interface. Once data is updated in the XML, it does not reflect in HTML without making any change in the HTML GUI. So we have to update in the HTML GUI for making any reflection in its presentation. Next advantage of XML is XML allows validation using DDD and XML schemas. This validation ensures that the XML document is free from any syntax error. So we use different type of parsers, just like a document object model DOM parser and SAX simple API parsers for validating the document type definitions and XML schemas for finding any syntactical error or any type of error. Next advantage of XML is XML simplifies data sharing between various systems because of its platform independent nature. XML data does not require any conversion when transferred between different systems. So this is also important feature of XML because we do not require any type of conversion while we are transporting the data from one system to another system. there are lots of advantages of using XML, but there are few disadvantages also. So XML syntax is verbose and redundant compared to other text-based data transmission formats such as JSON. JSON is also used for transmitting and storing the data. So as compared to JSON, it is very redundant. The redundancy in the syntax of XML causes high storage and transportation cost when the volume of data is large. So when the data is large and when we want to transmit the large amount of data or want to store the large amount of data, in that case the redundancy, we have to pay for the redundancy. So it causes the higher storage and the cost of transportation. The another disadvantage is XML document is less readable compared to other text-based data transmission format like JSON. Another disadvantage of XML is it does not support arrays. The next disadvantage of XML is XML file size are usually very large due to its verbose nature. So it is totally dependent on who is writing it. So it is also programmer dependent that how he is writing the code for the XML file. So it is very large due to verbose nature. So any can depend, programmer dependent. So it is programmer dependent. So these are the disadvantages of the XML, but XML have lots of advantages, and most of the recent programming languages which using the XML. So there are some lots of XML applications. So XML applications are software programs that process and manipulate data using XML technologies, including XML, XSLT, XQuery, XML schemas, XPath, and web services, etc. So uses of XML. So here are the uses of XML in web development and enterprise applications. One is the web publishing. It is very important application of XML in the web publishing. So XML allows the developer to save the data into XML files, and the use of XSLT transformation. So APIs to generate the content in record format such as HTML and XHTML or web markup languages. XML, another use of the XML is web searching. If your application, you can use the XML data and then the search the data from the XML files and display to the users. Similarly, data can be displayed in a different format to the users. For example, you can use Flex to create the charts and then use the XML file to feed the data into charting application. Then your Flex application can display the data into tabular and graphical format. So another advantage of using the XML is in web searching. The next use of XML is to data transfer. You can use XML to save configuration or business data for your applications. The XML file can be stored, used, transferred to another programs. E-business application, the next application or uses of XML in e-business application. XML is ideal solution for electronic data interchange. Next is the metadata application. So in many application, XML file is used as a metadata. So metadata is with data about data. For example, in Java based web application, web.xml file is used. Yes. Creating other languages. This next use of XML is to create the other languages. So many languages are created using XML, like WML, that is the web markup language. Another is MathML, math markup language, etc. The another use of the XML is in the use of databases. So modern databases such as Oracle, MS SQL Server is providing the XML support in their databases. So there are lots of applications or of XML in various programming languages. Also, we can say it is used to create a new programming languages for web or web services. Thank you very much.